I suppose I shouldn't be doing this when I'm having a tough day, but I'm gonna do it anyway because y'all have been on my mind. And hi, I'm Dave. 2 years ago, tomorrow, I ended up in Lionsgate Hospital, and well, I'm no stranger to hospitals. I was just figured I was invincible, and this was another thing that would sort itself out for at least 3 months. My backpack sat by the door, my computer in it, ready to get back in action. I made little videos, and 3 months I thought I'll be back in action at the most. In 6 months, and I moved downtown, and then there was just 6 months I can't remember, and then there was another 6 months of me trying just to get back to some sort of stability, and then 3 months of back bearing down and medical appointments and so on. But there's a couple things that I have to say out loud for my own benefit. One, thanks all of you who have supported me with your cards and letters and phone calls and whenever I'm losing my shit, you know, and you can tell kind of when I'm having a bad day because that's when I blarb all over the internets and, you know, the social web has become my therapy room. So thanks to you guys. Dear folks, with this sickness, collection of syndromes, whatever the fuck's going on, it's more common in women, and there's been a handful of women who have similar ailments who have been particularly nuanced with their kindness, and I have incredible appreciation for them. Because they're going through so much crap themselves. Second of all, yeah, there's months I don't remember. And there's times that I've come across people on the street and I can barely get a sentence out. Barely remember who people... There's also times that I've called people and strung out manicness. There's times that I've needed rescuing from strange places. There's times that I've been a total jerk. I know, I don't remember, but I suspect. Yeah, I know. None of this was my intention. I never thought I would be this guy. But that's, and so I know there's no need to apologize, but my pardon is for anyone who I've been rude to or impolite or something during this thing. Third thing is, as I've sort of been coming out of this haze, I've been trying to figure out who I was, and that means going, watching these videos, and I'm like, who that guy, man, he's funny, he's got a hat. I'm a different dude now, but I've been doing a lot of backwards and trying to recalibrate to try and be that guy again. That stops today. I love things that I've accomplished so far in my life. I'm up to almost 45 years of making shit, and I love it, and I miss it desperately, but I still am doing it just in a different way, man. But anyway, the point of this is, past awesome, future, that's where I'm looking. I know I need to get to this point of acceptance with what's going on. Sometimes doctors say this is the new normal and this is your life now. I'm totally I struggle with this a lot, right? I'm kicking and screaming because I have revolutions to lead and things to do. And I know that there's things I can do in my modified state because, you know. But I need to get comfortable with that. I've always been sort of this overperformer, maybe, or really maybe took pride. Pride's kind of become an ugly word, but I took a certain satisfaction in working hard and surprising people and making things awesome, and, you know, I just have to recalibrate to figure out what that new normal is. It will be remarkable, but, yeah, the past is the past. The future is unwritten. I don't know what this looks like yet. I've been on this hamster wheel of medical appointments and feeling like, oh my God, I can't wait to get back into action. And, you know, my the company, it's going, incredible things are happening, and I miss bringing on new talent and nurturing and mentoring them and telling my stories and inspiring others and doing my talks. That'll all come again, I know, but yeah, that all changes today. Yes, I do my postcard therapy and my headspace and my blarging with all my radical transparency, which is completely accidental. There's no political statement about that. I just need someone to blarg this stuff out loud to. So thanks for paying attention. Yes. Thanks. Pardons. Past is the past. The future is unwritten. My name is Dave. I have nothing but love and affection for all the kind people in the world. I do my best to stay optimistic and remove the grumpiness. With my collection of syndromes, I'm incredibly sensitive to everything, light and noises and chaos and commotion and energy. And I also don't know which days are going to be good days and which days are going to be not good days, so it's terribly hard to schedule anything with anyone. So for all of you who are waiting on a cup of tea and a conversation and all that, I want to be that guy. I'm just not that guy right now. It takes everything I can do to get up and find the right bus, which doesn't always happen. Yesterday I ended up at Marpole, 63rd and Granville. Fuck am I, man? What happened? Right bus, wrong direction. yeah, the adventure happens whether I want it to or not. And I hope you're coming along on whatever continued adventure I'm on. Remind me of the future if you feel inclined. Also, these dear folks in Nepal, I put my heart in with them. Compassion is a powerful thing for me right now. So I appreciate those of you who have responded to that call. And thank you, hey? And yeah, if you want a postcard, I know people sent their addresses and then I forget, and then postcards don't make it. They get chewed up in the mail. Maybe it's my handwriting. I don't know. I've sent over 150 of them in the last 2 years, actually really the last year, but I don't know how many of them actually made it, but I'm doing them for me, not just for you. I will close with this one here. This is the first watercolor painting I ever made. This was in Rot unter Rüttberg, Germany in 1993, somewhere in there. I was hitchhiking my way around Europe, met up with my pal Trauben. We lived in a tent right here, out front of which I painted this picture. This is, memories are powerful. Art saves lives. I'm grateful for friends. Goodbye.